Live from the Dude's Kitchen and Grill Studios in a garage somewhere outside of Boise, Idaho, it's your Wednesday night barbecue and talk show. And now your hosts, the Dude and Monica. Hey everybody, how you doing out there? Hope everybody's good. Welcome to the Dude's Kitchen and Grill's Wednesday night barbecue and talk show. We got a good one for you tonight. This is actually our first show. We got Captain Picard on with us. We'll have Captain Kirk on with us. Got my Lebowski 2020, This Aggression Shall Not Stand, for President shirt on. Captain Kirk, Captain Picard. We're going to start with Captain Kirk. I got some questions here. So thanks for showing up, Captain Kirk. Really appreciate it. There's Monica.
Hi. Sorry about that.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with Facebook. I wish I knew. But. So anyhow, introduce Captain Picard and Captain Kirk. I'll bring Captain Kirk over here. He's being socially responsible.
Woo!
He's got his mask on. Appreciate that, Captain Kirk. Where are you going? Gosh, I think he already took off on us. What a loser. Yvonne, how are you, buddy? Glad you could show up. Captain Kirk, let's ask Captain Kirk a question or two. So, Captain Kirk, you've had many, many adventures on the Enterprise. What is it with you and Orion's slave girls? Tell us what's going on with those.
Well, I honestly don't know what to think right now about that. But in the future, I hope that I can have a whole party.
A whole party of them. Did you hear that, Monica?
I did.
A whole party of slave girls. Okay. Kirk, I really want to say thank you for being, socially aware of life, everything. Got your face mask on, social distancing, etc. Captain Kirk's probably wearing a wig there, too. Are you wearing a wig, Captain Kirk?
No, it's actually my luscious hair. I like to eat a lot of carrots when I was younger. They decided to grow in a lot thicker than intended it on being.
Okay, so you're from Iowa. Do they grow a lot of carrots there?
No, actually, they grow a lot of onions.
Onions, okay.
So our armpits always smell like onions.
Scott, how are you? Glad you could make it. Captain Kirk, quick question for you. What's your favorite meal?
If I had to choose, being from Iowa, my favorite meal would have to be beef, so I would have to go with a filet mignon.
A filet mignon, okay. Barbecue or replicator food?
Replicator food.
Okay, I like it. Christmas meal. You're on the Enterprise. It's Christmas. What are you going to make?
I would honestly make a nice medium rare ribeye with some nice mashed potatoes on the side with maybe a little bit of greens.
All right. Well, thanks for showing up. You're out of here, buddy. Captain Picard, your turn. You're from Le Bar, France. Tell us a little bit about... your favorite mission on the Enterprise since you're from Le Bar, France?
It would honestly have to be the Orion slave girls.
You're Orion slave? You like Orion slave girls?
Indeed.
Okay. If you could have one person over for dinner, who would it be? Don't say Orion slave girl.
No, it would have to be an Orion slave girl. I would have to have at least three or four of them just to be satisfied.
Okay. All right. Orion slave girl for dinner. All right. Barbecue or replicator food?
Barbecue.
Oh, my gosh. And what would your Christmas dinner be on the Enterprise?
Probably a nice macaroni and cheese made with Velveeta. Something nice white trash.
You're into white trash?
I'm into white trash. Those white trash enchiladas that you had on the show the other year, those had to have been my favorite.
All right. And do you think Kirk would eat triples as well for Christmas?
Probably.
Who's better, you or Captain Kirk?
He has the better looks, but I have the better voice.
All right. Well, hey, thanks, Captain Picard. You're out of here, brother. All right, guys, there you go. There's our first two guests down. I forgot to ask them if they like cilantro or not. I'm going to put them down as one and one just because... some people like cilantro, some people don't. Anyhow, let's give it up for my son, Chris. Come on by, Chris. He was our Captain Kirk, Captain Picard. I think he did a great job. So, yay, good job, Chris. Monica, where are you at? Where are you at, Monica? Where are you at? But anyhow, I'm going to, this part of the show is brought to you by White Russians. Thank you, Yvonne, for commenting on how diverse we are. I really appreciate that. Hoping Monica makes it back on. Not sure she's got a bad connection or what she's got going on there. Anything else going on with anybody out there? Boy, these live streams, I'm telling you, you try to get two or three people together to chit-chat, it's like, holy crap, this ain't easy. Monica's back. Welcome back, Monica.
Hello. I had a little technical difficulties there for a moment.
Yeah, that's all right.
We're back now. Yeah.
Monica, what do you think about my shirt? Lebowski 2020.
Hey, that's pretty hot. Where'd you get that?
At a store.
Don't. Yeah. Thought maybe a fan sent it to you.
No. I don't have fans. I just have followers.
Yeah.
So we got awesome. Captain Kirk and Picard down. Uncle Pickles out there said Kirk would like to eat tribbles for Christmas. Probably would. Steven's out there. Hello, Steven. Steven and Jacqueline. Dig it. How's the homework going tonight, Steven? So, and I think Yvonne's out there from Food Galore Mexico. That's a channel you got to check out. He's got a cool channel. So, anyhow, let's get to know our hosts a little bit. You want to start?
Who are you? You tell us, who are you?
I am just some guy who has always loved to cook and always wanted to have my own talk show. That's who I am.
That's awesome. Yep. There should be more talk shows with the dude.
I agree.
The Big Lebowski.
I agree.
Yeah.
You hear he has lymphoma. So.
Oh, really?
The other dude, yeah.
I did not know this.
It came down to him or me for the role, and he got it. So, I, you know, it's kind of bummed. I like Jeff Bridges. As an
actor. Yeah, I didn't know that. That's really sad, actually. Yeah. Bummer deal. Yep. Well, cool.
Uncle Pickle says his name is Reginald. Okay.
Oh wait, is this Reginald?
Reginald?
Is this Reginald? Like our Reginald?
I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
Reggie.
Reggie. Yeah.
Yeah. He would be fun to have.
I know he would be a lot of fun. Huh? We should get him too. All right, Mr. Pickles. And how come we don't have anybody else on this video?
Well, it's right now it's just you and me. We'll open it up here in a bit.
We have Mr. Pickles.
We do. All right. You got any more questions for me?
Yes, I do. So, I know this is actually, you know, still pretty new for you, but have you thought about who else you might want to bring in as a guest? You know, a celeb that we could hunt down and ask. Let me stalk him.
I would go with Reginald from Trinidad to begin with.
I've heard a lot about him. It sounds like that would exactly. That'd be fun.
And mom. Yeah. Yeah. If I had to pick a celebrity, I would pick Jeff Bridges. I really would. Jeff Bridges would be fun. I've heard that he can cook really well.
Cool.
And, be nice to have him dressed up as the dude as well.
And yeah, maybe we could get him. That would be really cool, actually.
He could take over your spot.
What? Maybe not. Dun. As he creeps out.
Yeah.
Well, definitely. Have to see what we can do to get him on. I think that would be fun.
Well, 6 degrees of separation, right?
Right, exactly. And I usually make it one.
You do. Yeah.
0 to 1. Right. Hi, surprise. It's your best friend that you really didn't know you had.
Yeah.
But wish you'd known all your life.
Exactly.
Anyways,
what else? You got any other questions? Come on, rattle.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Team cilantro or no cilantro?
Cilantro. Yes, I'm team cilantro.
Do you put a lot of cilantro in your food?
No, this is so powerful.
It really is. Yeah.
Put a bunch of it on there.
I'm team no cilantro.
No cilantro. So I've got a thing back here. I will.
Yeah, could you mark me down, please?
See it here?
Oh, wait a second. I like this. We got to bring it into view some more. I like it.
There you go.
I like it.
Now there's a guy out there named Chris from Eastland Farms. I know for a fact when he comes onto the show, he will be a no. He likes to shoot cilantro.
He likes to shoot cilantro.
I try to make 0 inches of separation. Okay, Reginald, I like it. Yeah, Reginald, he's just out there, you know, chatting away.
Old chit-chatty. So, yeah, actually, I tried to get to, I didn't see anybody out at on our Facebook Live, so, but I did leave a note directing people to come to this YouTube channel.
Thank you so much.
You bet.
Right on.
You bet. Oh, what else you got for
me? Come on. What else? This is all about me right now. Oh, Monica.
I know. Look at me. Look at her go. Wait a second.
Yeah. Okay. Chris from Eastland Farms. Oh, nice. Nice. Yeah. Chris from Eastland Farms. He's on No Cilantro. So he's going to be a guest. He's a guest on the 11th. And we'll put him down officially for No Cilantro.
Okay, how are you marking these? Are you marking them as people show up and are, you know, interviewed?
Yep.
Or
yep.
Okay, all right.
Interviewed.
Because I'm thinking that there are going to be No Cilantro or Un Poquito Cilantro, which is I don't mind.
We could put Poquito in there, I guess.
Yes.
It's either yes or no. It's a yes or no question.
It really, yeah. So if in a yes or no situation, I'd say no. All right. Well,
you're down for now.
Yeah. So, how long have you been cooking? Like, you know, who inspired you growing up? What made Mike be the dude that wants to cook?
Be the dude loving in the movie The Big Lebowski and taking second place at a dude lookalike contest once.
Really?
Yeah.
Very cool.
My stepdad is probably the one who inspired me the most to cook. That guy can cook like you not believe, whether it be on a Weber kettle like we did in the old days, before we had stoves and ovens and that, you know, we cooked outside.
And then we've got to get him on the show then.
I don't think Bruce would want to do that. But no, he's actually a really good cook. The guy
can really cook. Huh. So do you remember like the age you were when you said, you know what, I want to do that?
You know, I was probably about 10 when I first decided that I was going to flip my first hamburger and hot dogs on the Weber kettle that we had out back.
Yeah.
And then Weber kettles kind of went away for a while.
Yeah.
But you got to read Eastland Farms' message.
Okay. So this is probably why Jean married you. By the time you were of age, you probably, you know, could cook everything then, huh?
You know, I didn't. I did a little bit as a kid and kind of growing up here and there, but my stepdad always did it for us. And so one day we were sitting there and I saw some guy cooking, I think it was like pancakes on a grill. And I thought, man, I could do that. And we happen to have a gas grill. And so I proved that I could do it.
And Gene says you couldn't.
Yep.
Huh. So maybe Gene taught you a thing or two, huh?
Just very possible. Yeah. Yeah, thanks, Chris. Yeah, you know us. I'm not gonna say it. I'm not gonna say it, Chris.
I saw it.
Not being radish. I know. You're not being radish, Chris. I appreciate that.
Like, what makes you think that I'm Hispanic? Is
boy, I don't know.
Would that make you radish? I think that makes him radish.
Yeah. You know,
are you profiling?
He's radish.
Right. That's it. That he's radish.
I like radish people. They're all right. A little on the red side, but
those foodies.
Those radish foodies. They like everybody, but apparently Cubans and cilantro.
And cilantro.
No, what is it? Pequeña.
Un poquito.
Un poquito, yeah. None of that, Chris. Except for Chris.
Chris. You like Chris, though.
Yeah, it's weird. Chris just noticed that Gene has the same last name as me. That is weird.
That is so weird.
I don't know, Chris. I think this is a setup.
I've actually had Jean's cooking though, and I'm thinking maybe she might have swayed you, been your influencer at one time, huh?
Probably in my adult years, yeah.
When you're younger, maybe? She's pretty hot, so you probably pay attention more then, huh?
I probably wasn't watching her cooking. I just kind of watched from behind. Oh, boy, there's a foul right there.
Well, so, yeah. Anyways, you want to tell a little story about Gene? How come you don't bring Gene on one of these days, huh?
Probably will one of these days. Gene actually made... Okay, here's my story. And I don't have it with me. She needs to bring it out here. She made a magazine, a national magazine.
Shut the front door.
Yeah. The thing just came in today. I wish.
Congratulations, my genie.
I wish I had a copy of it. I don't. I'll have to get it on the break.
That's awesome. Yeah,
she made a national magazine. If Uncle Pickles was still on, he saw it earlier when I was on Charlie Pickles.
I'm so proud of you, girl.
Yeah, she did a great job. So, she's the featured photographer, and then she also got the, they call it a centerfold. And it's not centerfold like I was thinking back in the day. But oh, she made two issues. So
that is so cool. That's great. I have to check it out. Yep. Sweet. Yeah.
Showed her in a little bit.
Yeah. So, was she also doing some food pictures?
Yeah, she does. Well, yeah. You know, she does a lot of weddings
for restaurants
and kids and stuff like that. But yeah, she has done some restaurants. And then she's also done some of the shots that I do for thumbnails.
Oh, that's cool. Right on. Very cool.
Apparently, Chris from Eastwind Farms was also on the chat earlier. So he saw the magazine. So,
yeah, what chat was this?
There's a guy named Charlie. Charlie Pickles.
And, okay.
He went live, and I thought, you know what the hell? I'm going to hop on his stream. He's great. Charlie's a character. He was looked like he was about to fall asleep on camera there for a while. And he just gets up and leaves.
That's why. Like, that's why I like. This is what you got to do.
Yeah. Exactly.
I'm awake.
It's funny because you're just like, Charlie, where'd he go? And it's like, oh, that plant really ties the room together. You know? All you see is a chair and a plant for about a minute. Like, okay.
Oh, that's funny. So, so you didn't go to Alaska, right? You were at the your normal yearly trip to Alaska, and
I did not
change there.
Yeah, just COVID. COVID was going strong at the time that I normally book.
As if it's not now.
I know, but when we were there, we would have been up during the earthquake that hit, right?
Oh, my really Lanta!
Close. So, Patrick from Patty Joe Cooking, what up, cousin? Ah, thank you. Yeah, look at this, Patrick Lebowski, 2020. This aggression shall not stand, man. That is my mantra. That is how I'm running this year. So, got it going.
So they're gonna go next year then?
Oh yeah, I plan on it, definitely.
Yeah, hopefully this pandemic is over by then. Good Lord.
I don't think it's ever gonna be over. It's
crazy. It feels like it. That's remember when Trump said that it'd be over in April? Yeah. I was just thinking about that today. I'm like, dang.
I wish he was right.
I wish he was right. Yep. Yeah. So anyways, what else we got going on?
Well, I have questions for you, unless you're done with me.
No, shoot. You go for it. We'll just go volley. How's that volley?
All right, this is for Monica. What is your favorite dish to make?
My favorite dish to make is, I'm really bad with pasta. I love pastas and rices. Like, Spanish rice is probably my favorite.
Okay. I don't know. Do your kids love it?
Oh, yeah, they love it. But love you got to go, you know, like, that's like my go-to real quick, you know, thing. You know, like a side dish to make with anything. So, like, if we're having roast beef. Oh, and Spanish rice.
There you go.
What else are we going to have, Mom? Spanish rice.
Yeah. Tomatoes in it. Yeah.
Yeah. Why are you asking? Because it's easy.
What was your favorite dish growing up?
Well, I have a lot of them. My mom is a really good cook. So, God, there's so many. It's hard to choose. But probably lazy enchiladas. She does this.
Oh, you told me about those ones.
Yeah, we gotta do that sometime. But it's like enchiladas. You make like the enchilada sauce with the red sauce, and or you could do it with green and the corn tortillas. Except the corn tortillas and the meat and the onion and the garlic, all that jazz. you're actually mixing it all into like a big soup. Gotcha. And your tip, like and then the tortillas, you actually rip them up and put them in there.
Okay.
So it's really, really good. Well, we'll have to make it someday.
All right.
Yeah. What about you?
My favorite.
What's your favorite?
Hamburger gravy over mashed potato. It's something we used to have as kids. I still love it to this day. I mean, it's got 60, 70 food written all over it. And I could eat that, especially the gravy. With a good country gravy, I'm a country gravy person.
That's the white gravy, right?
Yep. So for you, country gravy or brown?
I love brown gravy.
Brown gravy, okay.
I love brown gravy. And you know, something that I didn't know people like didn't have in their homes was my mom and my grandma, they always browned flour, you know, for cooking. When they're basically just making a gravy or a soup or anything, and they need a thickener, they brown flour when they first buy it, and you keep it like in a mason jar or whatever, you know, on the side of the stove with your spices. And we didn't buy like shillings or whatever. I think maybe they did a little bit, but we made our own gravy. It basically is what it was, and but people don't do that. I didn't know that wasn't a thing.
I had no idea that people would do that in advance. Makes sense.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. That's great. It makes it really nutty, you know, so it's not like you're just throwing the flour in there to make a gravy. It just gives it a nutty flavor.
Okay. Fair enough.
Yeah.
What's your favorite barbecue food?
Oh, I love me some ugly babies. Those are the best.
We're talking about that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Explain just what an ugly baby is.
An ugly baby is if you go to the butcher block, you know, whatever, the butcher, and you're going to ask them for, they're ugly babies. Some of the butchers know what it is already, but they might call it like riblets. But what it is the scraps, the odds and ends, the ugly pieces of baby back ribs when they're cutting baby backs. Yeah. And OMG, it is delish.
Nice.
The best meat. I don't even know why they don't sell them. Like, you can't just, like, go into, like, you know, Albertsons and, you know, find them. You basically have to go to the butcher and ask them.
Okay.
But you can find them, like, at Winco. But Winco kind of has an odd demographic. Like, they get a lot of Hispanics and, I think, different cultures there just because of their low, low prices. Gotcha. And they will usually sell them as riblets.
Okay. Here's a question for you. This is going around in comments. Split pea soup. Chris made it today. Patrick says he loves it.
I love me some split pea. Did you put a ham hock in it or ham?
Come on, Chris. Ham or no? Ham or no, Chris?
What? Because stores don't cut their own. Oh, I see. Okay.
I can tell you right now, Gene loves split pea soup. I'm not a fan of it. I will eat it.
I love it.
But I'm just not a big fan of it. I know.
What about lentils? Do you like lentils?
I do like lentils.
Lentils are the bomb.
I just don't.
We usually have a split pea soup like after Thanksgiving or Christmas, whenever you would normally cook a ham. You know, there's like 8 different dishes that you can get out of a ham, Grandma says. You know, so you buy the ham with a bone in it, and then after it's like all decimated from after a holiday meal, then you take that bone and you can make soups and anyways. Okay. That's when we throw that in with beans. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Looks like we got Craig online. Craig, split pea soup or not? Somebody's getting a pay cut. I might be in the minority on this one. I'm a minority here today.
Ham, onions, peas, yep, salt, and
pepper. Does that make me radish?
It makes you radish for sure.
And our guest next week happens to be Craig from Behind the Garage Barbecue.
Yeah, that'll be exciting.
Yeah, exactly. View from the Man Cave, Frank, my friend, how are you? Good to see you on here. Frank's getting hungry. He's hearing us talk about baby back ribs and split pea soup. I'll have to get Frank on here one of these days and see if he's team cilantro or not.
For sure. Yeah. So, so what's coming up here soon? What's the next holiday we got coming up?
Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving.
We're trying to get our the guests, trying to get Steven on from Cooking with Steven and Jacqueline, get his twist on how they would do a turkey in Trinidad and Tobago.
That would be cool. Yeah, that would be cool.
Trini style. I think that'd be awesome.
Do they do pigs? Do they do like the bury the pigs kind of cooking or no?
I don't know.
Or do they even do pork?
We'll have to see what he says.
Yeah, that would be cool. That'd be yummy.
Yeah. We got Hobby online. We got Rick online. Oh, my goodness, man. This is awesome. Love it, guys. Love it.
Well, we're moving on up.
Yeah, exactly. All right, guys. If you missed it earlier, here it is. Yeah, Kirk got tossed.
Oh,
here it
cool.
is. Jeans That's magazine awesome. That she's in. And I'm going to show you her centerfold.
Please do. Good job, Jean. I'm so proud of you. That's awesome. I love that picture.
Yeah. And then there is, it's somewhere here. Somewhere in here. I'm just showing off my wife's work.
She does a great job.
Dude. I know
the
missus. I know I missed it. Probably that one page and I skipped somewhere. She is their featured person.
Yep, Craig's on next week.
Yep, Craig, digging it. It's gonna be fun.
Yeah.
Chris from Eastman Farms is here on Veterans Day.
Sweet.
Ask him about his cats.
Is it Chris, aren't you a veteran? I think he's a veteran, huh?
Yeah, he was in the Marine Corps.
Yep, that's awesome.
Oh yeah. Thank you for your service. I'd be damned if I could find Jean's working here now, other than the centerfold. No, we had
some stuff. I bet if it was a centerfold, you could find it real
quick. Yeah, definitely. Well, anyhow.
In another magazine, maybe?
Maybe. Anyhow, it's in here. She's got another thing for it, so I'm sorry, honey. So, yeah. Sorry.
Very cool.
Selfless plug for the wife. So
that's okay.
Yeah. I think what I love about this group that's on here right now is just the diversity in cooking. You know, everybody just has a different style from Trini style to Patrick, who just makes whatever the hell he wants, and Chris shooting cilantro. So
Mike, if you could,
else in between.
In your, how would you describe your cooking in three words? What kind of cooking does Mike do?
Three words? I could do it in two. Experimental cooking. I never really make the same thing twice.
Really? I'm
always striving for that next thing. So
what do you make on you have a low on time and you just want to throw something together? You don't have like a go-to?
Eggs and bacon or quesadilla.
Quesadillas.
What I really like is, like I was explaining earlier, is I did... I made ribs the other day, and after I put them in the foil, I kept them on for 2 hours and took the ribs off, because the last half hour or so, you're supposed to have them naked on the grill, but there's all this juice, so I poured this juice into a pan and then started adding stuff to it, thinking, this would be good, and it went way on the acidic level. I mean, you could taste the mustard, the vinegar in there and that, so then I tried to bring it back with pineapple and apple juice, and it just didn't work out. That's just it. Sometimes you hit that home run and sometimes you strike out. It's just the way it is.
Yeah. Sometimes I do that with when I'm making my own barbecue sauce. I'll put some liquid smoke in there I'm not sure what I'm thinking at the time, but a couple of times I've made it now, I put way too much liquid smoke in there and it's like, whoa, that is bad.
So yeah, I've liquid smoke's one of those things. It's just a drop.
A drop will do ya. Yeah, that is right.
Yeah. So let's see what else we got here.
Yeah, let's see.
Breaking news. Jeff Bridges' house was just burglarized. His bathrobe was reportedly stolen. I thought we were friends, Chris. Damn it.
I think we should bring some folks on, man.
Steven says, yes, they do the whole pig underground cooking thing.
That's cool. That's really cool. Awesome.
All right, guys. Yeah. Well, that's it for our guests. I'm going to open it up for everybody to come visit.